teaching you verbal and non-verbal communication, I should tell you what is communication, right?
Yes, sir.
So communication means conveying of ideas based on understanding. Where there is a communication, understanding must be there. Now, something is being said or told to you, and if there is no understanding, so that speech is not called a communication. Now, in the communication, message is there. And there are the two types of message. One is the verbal communication, another is the non-verbal communication. And verbal messages has got two further types. One is the oral communication, another is the written communication. And oral communication, when you are saying something orally, when you are saying something verbally to the people. Now, in the day-to-day life, how many times and at how many occasions we do the oral communication, we do the verbal communication? Every year. Suppose you are in the class, you are at home, you are with friends, wherever you are, you do the oral communication. Here I have written, like when you are doing the face-to-face communication. So have you done the face-to-face communication with somebody?
Yes,
so here you do the face-to-face? Face-to-face debates. Face-to-face debate. When you are doing a face-to-face communication, so this is called oral communication, means you are using words, you are using sentences, and also you are showing some emotions. That means along with the oral communication, you are using non-verbal communication. So that is on the next board, I'm going there. So then we have voice chat. Voice chat you are doing on the phone, like you are not seeing the party, you are not seeing the receiver, you are not seeing the person whom you are talking on the phone. So this is called the voice chat. So this is also the example of the verbal communication or the oral communication. Then we have the video conferencing, and you have many applications in the video conferencing, like you are doing the video conferencing nowadays on the Imo, on the Skype, on the Viber, on the Messenger, on the WhatsApp. So there are many, you know, applications are there. There are many types of video conferencing are there. So they all are the types of
communication.
Oral communication. They all are the types of oral communication, means where you are orally involving yourself in the communication. And another type of verbal communication is written communication. And you use the letters, documents, emails, text message, and the social media chat. Do you understand? You are writing messages, commands in the social media, on the Twitter, on the Facebook. Okay, now we move to the non-verbal communication. Non-verbal communication. And here I have written new things for you. You might have not heard them, you might have not known them in your life. Non-verbal communication means gestures, your body language, your frowns, your postures, the manner of your standing, how you are standing. You are not using words, but through your body you are conveying some message to the people by your facial expressions. Whether you are angry, you are happy, you are excited, means even a little child gets your message by your face. Even an animal can get your different behaviors on your face. So means verbal communication is important, but non-verbal communication is very important than the verbal communication. But you know, we are being taught just the verbal communication, and we just focus, emphasize, stress to learn and to do the verbal communication, but we never have thought and realized that non-verbal communication could be even important. So here I have written here the kinesics, artifacts. Can you read with me? Artifacts, proxemics, they are difficult. Okay, proxemics, phonomics, vocalics, haptics. Okay, now what is kinesics for all body languages? And you know, when you are sending text message, you are having some emojis. Have you seen some emojis? They are blinking you, they are showing you tongue, and they are opening their big mouth. The girls are very, you know, they aptly do this. They suppose if they write one line, then they give you the 10 emojis. Because they are very expressive. I don't know whether the boys, you might be very you know, inept in doing these things. So emojis means they convey your non-verbal communications, means how you are feeling at that message, how you are feeling at that message, these emojis. Okay? Okay, all body language means, all body language means your gestures. Now kinesics means your all body languages, your gestures, your postures, your eye contact, you know, your hand movement, you know, all these things, your frowns, your smiles, your nods, noddings, all these things come in the kinesics. Then we have artifacts. Artifacts means your physical appearance. Okay, when I have told that kinesics consume all the body language, then what about the artifacts? I have written here the physical appearance. Physical appearance means what you are wearing, means accessories, how many accessories you are using. You know, sometimes I've seen some people are wearing the chains. Okay, why? Because they want to convey some message. They are, you know, suppose if you are wearing wristwatch, if you are wearing some, you know, strip or band around your wrist, if you are wearing some rings, okay, and if you are wearing, you know, in your lobe of your ear something, you have pierced your ears, they are called the accessories. If you are wearing the opticals on your nose, people will give you the impression, okay, the person is wearing the glasses. When you are wearing the glasses and if you go to somebody, then what would be the first impression of yours? That the person is wearing the glasses, his eyesight is weak. Nowadays, people are wearing the glasses for the face value. This is another thing. But, okay, so means, artifacts means accessories, all the accessories. Dressing means dressings play very important role. Very important role. So in your non-verbal communication, means you have not even started the communication, and your artifacts means your physical appearance has started to convey the message to the receiver. Means your outlook, if it is bad, then bad impression. If it is good, means presentable. I don't say that it's very high profile, high class, full of things you all the time wear when you deliver the presentation. No. But at least you are supposed to be presentable. Okay, then we have proxemics. Can you read?
The distance of a speaker and receiver.
The distance of a speaker and receiver. The distance of a speaker. Now suppose this person, please come here. He is my receiver, and I'm talking to him, so I have to make a distance. I have to make a distance when I'm talking to him. If I am not making any distance to that person, then I'm not making any distance, and if he is a stranger, then not a nice communication will take place. Okay, so if that person is a stranger, then I have to make a distance. Not a distance, a big distance, means I have to make a good distance, a nice distance, means that is very much acceptable to that person. Okay, and sometimes suppose if you are free to your friends, you are not making any difference, you are not maintaining any difference, you are just, you know, hugging your friend, you are just, you know, touching very closely to that friend. Okay, आप उसके अंदर घुसते जा रहे हो when you are making some kind of communication. Okay, limitations. So proximity means the distance of speaker to the receiver, to the listener. So it's very necessary that you have to maintain. So means that should not be very large, or that should not be very much close. Then we have phronemics, how serious you are, how serious and how punctual you are when you are making communication. Serious, suppose you are talking and you are also using the mobile. Have you seen some people? They are talking and they are and they are lost in the Facebook. They are lost in the mobile. They are talking to you and sometimes they yes, they say like this. So that means this is such a bad communication. So phronemics means when you communicating, this is a non-verbal communication. So means you have to show to the receiver that you are very much interested. Then we have vocalics, volume, speech, tone. Last topic I told you.
Yes, sir.
I should not repeat it. Okay. Then we have haptics. Haptics, it's very interesting. The use of touch to express emotions and feelings. Means when you are talking to somebody, Have you seen some friends? They are giving you five. Give me five. Okay, like this. So have you seen some people? Why they do this? They are hugging each other. They are shaking hands. Have you seen?
Yes, sir.
So they are gestures. They are non-verbal communication. They are shaking hands. And have you seen some people shaking very tight?
Yes, sir.
They shake you very hard.
Yes,
so they are, you know, sending some message. And sometimes they are shaking very loose. And sometimes they don't shake you, they just say like this. Assalamu alaikum. So this is haptics. Haptics means touch. When they are touching girls, they touch a lot while doing communication. They touch a lot while doing communication. So miss, today I taught you the verbal and non-verbal communication. Verbal communication that you do the face-to-face, and non-verbal communication means you do through your expressions. And they are the types of non-verbal communication. Thank you very much.